past 4 years, or I'd say the best part of 4 years, I've been suffering with anxiety. And it's obviously it's my health. So my health was my first priority. That was my main priority. And it was starting to affect my performance in cricket. And I think taking time out is a way of obviously trying to fix me as a person and to prolong my career, basically. I want to think that, like anyone, if your performance drops, then you have that capacity to get dropped. So I didn't want to allow it to affect my performance enough that that happened. And hopefully if I can fix myself off the field, then, yeah, like I say, I can prolong my career.
Sarah, how would this anxiety typically manifest itself? And how would it affect you, particularly at its worst?
At its worst, I think it's a panic attack. It's quite simple as that. There's ways and kind of depths in which it can kind of hit you. On the cricket field, or it happened mainly when I was just about to bat, that kind of expectation of wanting to score runs, that was the hardest. Obviously the nerves would hit me, but it would be nerves plus something else, and I was always confused as to what it was. But now I know, it's a genuine kind of panic, and the heart races, you kind of feel faint. Those are just little things that I go through, and there has been times where I've had to run off into the changing rooms and be sick sometimes, just through sheer panic, and that's where it's got to really in terms of my cricket. And yeah, like I say, that then in turn affected my performance, and it had to be addressed.
Sarah, we've had a recent period with women's cricket where the profile has gone up considerably, I think, and it's become professional. And you are one of those players, and I'm as guilty as this as anybody, of saying, well, Sarah Taylor, what a great player. You know, the way you keep wicket, the way you bat, you've gone and played men's cricket, grey cricket in Australia. Has that contributed to the sense of pressure that you felt under Sarah? Has that contributed to the condition?
Yeah, it has to. I think that's quite a natural thing. I think the biggest thing for me was the expectation that I put on myself. That was the biggest thing that kind of triggered a lot of attacks, and obviously putting myself in those situations were to test myself in the cricket front, and see if I could reach that level. But in turn, that obviously added to my anxiety, and it was kind of a double-edged sword really in that. But I knew that if I wanted to push myself in my cricket, that I would have to go through it, and I just sort of accepted it and just kind of went with it. And but I just think that, yeah, the way the game is going, this is probably a good time for me to take a break and actually fix myself, and this is the most important thing for me at the minute. And yeah, like I say, I've said, just getting myself better.
Now, your decision to do that, and in fact, you know, your decision to come and talk to me about it today, the fact that we've had Marcus Trzaskowski and Michael Yardy or Monty Panesar, I mean, every condition is different, but in the general sense of a mental, emotional health thing affecting, has their experiences made it easier or even possible for you to address it this way?
Well, yeah, I think there has to be a point where, from my point of view, I don't want any stigma attached with any kind of anxiety, depression, mental health, or I call it a mental injury, just because the same strategies are in place to deal with this as there would be just any kind of physical injury. So the fact that you know that other people are going through the same thing, and it's okay, it's normal, that's been the biggest insight for me. And knowing that they're having support as well, obviously the fact that Monty's just come out about it, there's been stuff on the BBC website about anxiety at the minute currently, and I think that the support that I've got through the ECB and from Mark Robinson has been incredible. This is a journey for me, but obviously I want it to be a learning for other people, that it's okay to go through something like this, but it's not okay to suffer in silence. And I think that yeah, to have the right people around you is really important, and luckily I've had that, and obviously they've had that as well.
Now, this is a time of considerable change in the England women's team. Mark Robinson has come in as the coach. And two players who you know very well, Charlotte Edwards, of course, and Lydia Greenway, are now not part of things. Is that in any way linked to your decision to have a break from the team?
Not at all. Not in any way. Not even the slightest. Like I said, this has been going on for best part of 4 years now. And what I will say about Mark is that I've been in talks with him for the last couple of months, and he's just set an environment that is so open and honest that it was okay for me to mention this. It was okay for me to mention something that could potentially have that stigma attached to it, that it's not okay to mention it, that you kind of have to suffer, on your own. And luckily he's been incredible. I speak to him most days, and yeah, like I say, he's been that huge support in me, and him and obviously the ECB have been incredible. They want the best support for me. They've shown me every door that I could possibly go down in terms of support, and the support that I am receiving has been incredible so far.
Everyone has an idea of how to deal with physical injuries, Sarah. You give you some anti-inflammatories and a surgery, I suppose, if it came to it, but mental injury. I mean, how do you deal with fixing yours?
Like I say, everyone's different, but in my case, I'm going through CBT, which is cognitive behavioural therapy, and it's a case of talking through my day-to-day things, talking through the struggles that I have on a regular basis, and then also looking a bit deeper into why my thought process is why it is, and my real kind of background stuff. And I'll just have little activities day by day that I need to tick off, and that will purely be in my personal life. And that's a case of once I'm comfortable enough in my personal life, I can then look to helping the cricket side of things, because ultimately, like I've said, my health is the most important thing, and then unfortunately my cricket has to come second.
Cricket's a funny old sport, isn't it, Sarah? And I mean, no, we love it, but you have this situation where you can be under huge pressure for a second, and it's a good delivery and you're out. And then you could be thinking about that for days, you know. Do you think that nature of the way cricket is has contributed to your situation? Or do you think the way your thought processes go, you would be in this situation, whatever you have done for a living?
I'm probably going to say a mixture of both. Yeah. I think the way that I approach my thinking, my thought process, I hid a lot behind humour. Everyone will be the first word on a sheet that describes me. A lot of people put bubbly but I think looking back at it was I hid a lot behind humour. So knowing that, I knew that my thought process was there, that in any job I think this probably would have eventually come about. But I would say that the pressures in cricket, and like you say, you've got so much time to think. Like you say, you can get out and then you're sat there for 5-6 hours thinking about it, and then someone will obviously write about it in the paper, and you can't help but read about it, or you can't help but check social media, and then you're constantly thinking about it again. But I would say on the flip side that even if I did something well, I'm the sort of person to kind of play it down and not belittle it, but just go, oh yeah, but I did this wrong within it. And that's me as a person, just like I say, I think that's why I think I would always have got to this point. But yeah, I think the expectations of cricket and the expectations of myself within cricket have been quite high.
Do you need to learn to be nice to yourself, Sarah?
Honestly, that's probably one of the things I have to do. It sounds so small and so tiny, but actually in progressing, being positive is a huge way of dealing with what I'm going through. And I don't know if that's the same with everyone else, but just my personal battle, that you have to be positive. And like even getting here on today, I have to be positive about getting here. It's just little tiny things and little tick boxes, like I say, that I have to get through. So yeah, the journey through cricket was obviously trying to be really positive towards the end, but just couldn't quite deal with it. But my anxiety has got worse since I've finished playing, because I tried to use it as a bit of a kind of forget about it, just get on with your cricket, you can just sort of divulge into your work, in any work really, in that sense. So now it's a case of trying to be positive in as many areas as I possibly can.
So in a way, you've almost taken off your mask, Sarah. Do you know what I mean by saying that? I mean, you've opened yourself up now because you haven't got the cricket as your identity, I suppose.
Yeah,
is that true? So
hugely.
Yeah.
It's also a tough kind of... actually, you're so busy playing cricket. Your days are planned. You know exactly what you're doing in the week, or your training and stuff like that. And actually, to take that away... gives you, unfortunately, a lot more thinking time, which is why it has got worse just after I stopped playing. But I think it was Ian Salisbury that said to me that you have to hit the bottom of the pool in order to swim back up. Mm. So I'd like to think that I've hit the bottom in the past month or so. So that's me being positive that I'm hoping to hit the top.
Well, here's a final point, and let's address this in a positive way.
Yeah.
I think it's probably impossible for anybody to say when you might play cricket again. But sitting here now, are you positive that you will play cricket again, Sarah?
I would like to say that I'm 99% sure that I will play. Mm. I think that I want to. I absolutely want to play cricket. I want to put an England shirt back on. I want to train with the girls. I miss them terribly. So it's a case of being realistic and knowing that I will do everything in my power to become healthy, to become or put myself in a position where I can go back and play again. But obviously, yeah, I can't say that that's going to happen. I don't know where it's going to go. But in a positive way, I want to play cricket again, and I hope to be back. Yeah.